Hey, what's going on, people? It's SGZ here from the Spartan Game Zone, and in this video, I'll be showing you a dedicated drop spot for the front loader in Borderlands 3. This is someone you can farm to get the front loader faster than anything else. Thanks to the person who suggested it, if you have a weapon or item that you want to know how to get fast, let me know in the comments and let's get cracking. The front loader has an increased chance to drop from private beans, who you can find at this area of the map in Athenus. Now, private beans may not be here for you, as you need to complete the quest Invasion of Privacy first. You can get this quest from Ava after you've met her on Athenus, and it'll take you about 7 minutes to complete, and you might lose a few brain cells from completing it. Once you have done it though, Private Beans will spawn. He is a Nog type enemy and is just as difficult as a typical Nog you'll encounter. The closest spawn point is a decent amount away and you can see it here. Without speed boost, it'll take you 30 seconds to get there, which is quite a long time, but what shouldn't take you a long time is getting a front loader to drop. I received 3 front loaders in the 15 times I killed him on Mayhem 4, and that's a nice 20% drop rate, but you may have different results. Mayhem 4 won't help you get one any faster than without Mayhem levels, but I suggest farming him on Mayhem 4 as you have a higher chance of getting an anointed frontloader, and he's still very easy to kill. Private Beans also has the Trevenator and Wester gun in his dedicated loot pool, so expect to see some of these as you farm for the frontloader. Both of these guns are good, but you'll want to avoid the Wester gun, unless it drops with a binary prefix. But what about the front loader? What does it pair well with? What would happen if you spread guacamole and hummus on some toast? Well, the front loader is a high capacity shield that reserves 60% of your max health and adds that to shields. This means that your health is capped at 40% while your shield grows an extra 60% bigger. This makes it suitable if your build is designed for maintaining shields, or if you have abilities that support shield recharge and delay over, say, lifesteal and regen. Most Vault Hunters will have builds aimed at the latter, but there is one item that is made to be paired with the front loader. That item is the Deathless Artifact, which you can see here, and you may already see why. Both the front loader and Deathless cap your health at certain marks. The front loader caps it at 40%, and Deathless caps it at just 1. Because it's lower, the Deathless takes precedent in that count, but you're also getting a 160% increase to your shields from the 2 items. The Deathless Artifact also increases its recharge rate by 25% and reduces its recharge delay by 20%. Not much shields work well with the Deathless, but the front loader does, and it's one of the best. These items in combination are perfect and are even better on Moe's if you're tapped into her skill that increases the damage the lower her health is. Because the Deathless caps your health at 1, you can take that full damage bonus to the party the whole time while having an extremely large shield. The front loader is great in this combination and is one of the highest capacity shields in the game. So that's all for this video. Let me know in the comments if you have an idea for a weapon or item that you want to know who drops it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, consider dropping a like or subscribing, and I'll catch you in the next one.